Christina, so let's go to Florida. It was after the last devastating hurricane in Puerto Rico when President Trump did so little to help Puerto Ricans, and many moved to the state of Florida. And over on shows like this, we said, this is really going to hurt him in Florida politically, but it's not. He is leading among Latino voters there. Why is that?
Democratic convention, we were complaining that there was no Latino representation. And then at the Republican convention, they were literally naturalizing citizens on the stage. He just needs to move 4 to 8% of that vote, and he's going to be reelected.
Because his message to the Latino voters in Florida is targeted at South Florida, mostly at the Cuban American votes, at the Venezuelans, the Colombians, Nicaraguans, even Central Americans that fled during the war in their countries and are terrified of socialism. It's the S word that President Trump has been mentioning over and over again, saying that a Biden-Harris ticket would be a return of the radical left, exactly the same reason why they left their countries.
Why is it that anyone believes that message about Joe Biden, Saul? Joe Biden has been in office for decades, and there is nothing super progressive or socialist about him. Why are people suddenly buying into this idea that Joe Biden's a radical, especially Latinos, when President Trump has said and done so many anti-immigrant things?
The Latinos are very entrepreneurial. Probably one out of every three or four families owns a business. So they do care about regulation. They do care about taxes. They care about their source of income.
And speaking of capitalism, give me just 30 seconds to tell you about this special offer from this episode's sponsor, BioTrust Ageless Multicollagen. After 20 years old, your body will naturally decrease its collagen production by 12% each passing decade. This is a leading reason as to why skin appears thinner and more wrinkled as we age. Ageless Multicollagen provides you with the 5 types of collagen your body needs and 1 complete protein. You'll enjoy powerful support for your body with results you can see and feel in a few short weeks. Get Ageless Multicollagen for 51% off plus free shipping by going to www.healthwithdronetech.com or by clicking the link in the video description box below.
Christina, so let's go to Florida. It was after the last devastating hurricane in Puerto Rico when President Trump did so little to help Puerto Ricans, and many moved to the state of Florida. And over on shows like this, we said, this is really going to hurt him in Florida politically, but it's not. He is leading among Latino voters there. Why is that?
They never learn, do they? It's that trademark lack of self-awareness that doesn't allow them to see past their own partisan bubbles. Perhaps it might have something to do with these stacked panels of like-minded partisans all just agreeing with the bullshit each other spews. However, in this case, there was some surprising candor about why Trump has gained the support of so many Latinos, to the point Trump is actually leading Biden with Latinos in Florida. The hilarious part is just how stupidly dumbfounded Stephanie Ruhle is. And it's not surprising because she's just a party hack for the Democrat Party, and she'll say whatever she needs to say to get them elected. It's not really hard to decode why Trump has this support, and it's pretty universal, I think. We all just don't like communism, we don't like socialism, and we want nothing to do with Marxism. Like him or not, Trump is the shining example of a successful American capitalist. I mean, even Barack Obama said that Trump is the example of the American dream. He personifies it, which I think is one of the reasons he has such large support from Latinos and is such a target by the left. Latinos who have fled their ideological far-left countries, sometimes risking their lives, aren't about to sign up with a bunch of people selling the exact same shit that destroyed the country they left. So basically what Ruhle is saying here is that the media had executed what they thought was a successful propaganda campaign against Trump after the hurricane while covering up or downplaying the rampant corruption going on in Puerto Rico.
Why is it that anyone believes that message about Joe Biden, Saul? Joe Biden has been in office for decades, and there is nothing super progressive or socialist about him. Why are people suddenly buying into this idea that Joe Biden's a radical, especially Latinos, when President Trump has said and done so many anti-immigrant things?
Here we go again. No, he has not said many anti-immigrant things. This woman cannot get through a sentence without lying. She's basing this lie off past media lies, claiming that Trump called immigrants animals, when in fact he was talking about MS-13 gang members. That lie went around a really long time and kept popping up. I haven't seen it recently, but it's a lot like the Very Fine People lie. It's something that they keep bringing up as proof of Trump's racism, but it's all made up. Then there's the time he said that some illegal immigrants are rapists and criminals, and then the media completely misrepresented what he said and claimed that he was calling all Mexicans rapists and criminals. Then there was that time that Nicole Wallace of MSNBC actually claimed that, quote, Trump is talking about exterminating Latinos.
President Obama used the power of the presidency to try to pass comprehensive immigration reform with the Latino community, Latino leaders at the table. You now have a president, as you said, talking about exterminating Latinos.
She later released a non-apology claiming that it was some sort of a mistake, but it just goes to show you how desperate these people are to pull Latinos away from Trump.
Why is it that anyone believes that message about Joe Biden, Saul? Joe Biden has been in office for decades, and there is nothing super progressive or socialist about him.
Well, for one, he's being defended and promoted by the likes of Stephanie Ruhle, a person who openly mocks people that don't want to be socialists, on a network that was openly praising Fidel Castro after he died.
I'm speaking to you today because I have seen people like this before. I've seen movements like this before. I've seen ideas like this before. And I am here to tell you, we cannot let them take over our country. I heard the promises of Fidel Castro, and I can never forget all those who grew up around me, who looked like me, who suffered and starved and died because they believed those empty promises. They swallowed the communist poison pill.
Yeah. But lots of people don't get into the argument. They just go, oh my gosh, socialist, I can't have that. It's going to take all my money.
Not to mention Joe Biden's support and cover to far-left, self-labeled Marxist and communist movements that are currently promising increased violence if Biden is not elected. He's also stated that he would basically redistribute police funds to other areas, which some might call defunding the police. Another charge the media fiercely defends Biden against, playing PR spin-style semantic word games to deflect criticism. Not to mention the Democrat Party's general slide into increasingly far-left politics. So yeah, that's just a couple reasons off the top of my head why I would support Trump over Biden if I'm anti-socialist, Marxist, or communist. Hey everybody, thanks for watching. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. If you want to support this channel, you can do so by using one of the platforms listed in the description or pinned comment. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you next video.